Well, Father's Day is upon us, and I just want to share a few words of encouragement with all of you dads out there who may be struggling with or questioning your role within the family dynamic. You may be a little disheartened or downtrodden. You may not feel the support that you once did, or you may not be appreciated as much as you were when the children were much younger. And you're in that sort of purgatory of fatherhood where things just aren't what they used to be, and you're wondering if you really had any importance or any effectiveness at all whatsoever. And I want to tell you that you are important, and that that your role is absolutely crucial. And I'm going to demonstrate it here through a story that meant a lot to me, and I think it will with you likewise. See, the role of a father is to provide, protect, and to be present. And when I say present, what I mean is, the father is there to be a guiding light, a compass, a moral compass. He's supposed to be there so that the children feel like they have a safe place to go. Now, that might not always be evident to you, and it may not always be acting itself out, but understand that if you were not in the picture, things would be drastically different. And some of you know what I mean. There might be a fissure or a fracture within the relationship, and you might live in separate homes, and you've already seen the effect of that. But I can guarantee you that if you were completely gone, and I mean through death, you would see the family change in a much different way, sometimes for the better and sometimes for the worse, because your presence means a lot. Now, here's a good story that like I just said, here's a good story that I think will mean something to you. I found it in the June issue, this June's issue of Reader's Digest, and you can pick it up for yourself on any grocery store shelf or subscribe to it if you like, and you'll find it. But this article is called Dads on Duty. This is the cover of the Reader's Digest I'm talking about. And this article is found on page 12. It's very short, but I think it will exemplify everything that I'm trying to communicate here. All right. Here's what it says. On Thursday, September 16, 2021, just weeks into the school year, two groups of boys brawled across the courtyard at Southwood High School in Shreveport, Louisiana. The following day, two groups of girls picked up where the boys had left off. In a mere 2 days, 23 students were in police custody. One was charged with battery for allegedly hitting an assistant principal. Another student was charged with threatening a resource officer and a staff member. We hear about this kind of thing all the time, don't we? It's becoming quite prevalent, right? When a school administrator told her former classmate Craig Lee, a business owner and community activist, that gang tensions were rising, Lee wanted to do something. He contacted Michael Lafitte. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right, but that's how I'm going to say it. He contacted Michael Lafitte, a fellow activist who had an 11th grade daughter at Southwood. That Sunday, the two held an emergency meeting with parents and the principal. By the end of the four-hour session, a group of the fathers in attendance had decided it was time to make their presence known on campus. "We're dads," Lafitte told CBS News. The best people to take care of our kids are who? Are us. That's how Dads on Duty was born. Its goal? Make sure the kids are safe. Around 40 men organized into six-person shifts with two shifts on campus every day. They started the day after the meeting. The dads are business owners, truck drivers, chefs, and financial advisors who sacrifice their own schedules and commitments. Some are fathers of kids at the school, while others are uncles, grandfathers, brothers, and men like Lee, who doesn't have a child at Southwood, but wants the youth in his community to know that they have an entire village behind them. Now, anyone who wants to enter the school with rage and closed fists will have to dodge boisterous papa bears, big smiles, positive affirmations, and a plethora of awful dad jokes. You see what being present means? I like that. I mean, what a great example. It's hard to be a tough guy when somebody's uncle has just tricked you into checking your shoelaces for the umpteenth time, only to find out that they are not, in fact, untied. Since dads on duties arrived on campus, fights have drastically declined and gang battles have stopped completely. The school's been happy. You can feel it, said one student. Another told the Washington Post, they interact with all the kids like they were their own children. But it's not just corny jokes and bubbly good mornings that have healed Southwood. It's the positive presence promotion developed by dads on duty to make sure every student feels as if someone is invested in their success. That means taking an interest in home lives, engaging in dialogue about entrepreneurship and alternatives to gang culture, sponsoring essay contests, and ultimately making sure every kid has an adult they trust to turn to in times of crisis. The dads aren't meant to replace security guards or disciplinarians. If they do see a fight, they get security or an assistant principal on the scene ASAP. Their presence is meant to be more preventive than reactionary. For instance, one day after school, dad on duty Mike Morgan noticed that a student who'd been bullied was milling about outside with friends. Morgan suspected that they were lying in wait for the student's tormentor. Morgan found the bully and steered him clear of the area, likely avoiding an assault. That's a counterintuitive direction to take, isn't it? It was a situation requiring more delicacy and a personal investment than law enforcement or security might have offered. The Shreveport dads have already partnered with fathers in other parts of the country who have followed their example. Groups in Henderson, Nevada, Little Rock, Arkansas, and Jackson, Mississippi have formed versions of Dads on Duty, Lee says. As Lafitte told People magazine, the more the merrier. We'd like this to be the same as the PTA, something that is in every school in every country. The absence of fathers has been quite evident in our society, hasn't it? And it's acted itself out first in schools. But we can see what an impact it has when you're just there. You know, the difference that it makes, because they do view you different than their mother, than a woman. And there's nothing, that's nothing pejorative, that's nothing negative about women or mothers in general. It's just that this is what your role as a father does. And I want to tell you that what you are doing, just your mere existence makes a difference. So if you feel discouraged, if you feel disheartened, just take heart by this story. Just know that even if it's just a little difference, it's something. If you weren't here, it just wouldn't be the same. Let me leave you with a quote that I found this morning that really sums all of this up quite well. And the point of origin for this quote is not known, so I can't tell you who said it. But it says, a father is neither an anchor to hold us back nor a sail to take us there, but a guiding light whose love shows us the way. Guys, I hope that's meant something to you. If it has, hit the like button, subscribe, the notification bell, and share this with somebody else who needs to hear it, because I guarantee you that you know a friend, or you have a friend, I should say. You know, you have a friend, you know somebody who really needs to hear this. And also keep in mind, there may be a younger man, a child, or even a younger woman, I guess I should say. It doesn't come down to boys and girls, or a boy or a girl, but keep in mind, somebody may need you to be a father to them. Be present. They're looking for a dad. They might find one in the wrong place. Keep this in mind.